Hi there. We're going to talk about drawing comb. So that's the process of bees adding comb, beeswax comb, to the foundation we provide them in our frames. For bees to draw comb out, they need an intense nectar flow, but we can simulate that with feeding, as we've done in this situation. 2 weeks ago, we installed this nucleus colony, four frames of bees, into a brand new hive. New beekeepers are at a significant disadvantage with those brand new beehives because there's no comb for the bees to expand into. So that's a bit of a hurdle to get over when you first get into beekeeping. When you buy a nucleus colony, all the comb they have are on those four frames. If you have package bees where people use those, you'll be starting off with no comb at all. So we're going to talk through that process. I'll set the nuke out of the way here. We've put this feeder on 2 weeks ago, and we put a gallon and a half, 2 gallons of sugar syrup inside that feeder right at the time we installed the nucleus colony. And just pry that off, and there you can see how the bees are doing. There's the inside of the feeder, and you can see that it's quite empty. They've taken that all down. They built a lot of some excess beeswax here, and when I look down in between the frames, I can see some nice white capping wax. When beeswax is first produced by the bees, it's a pure white color. It gets travel stained from bees walking over it, so it goes more of a yellow color over time. So let's start. We'll pry that second frame out here. We'll lift that up slowly and carefully. And they haven't done anything on this side, but the frame is quite heavy because they have completely built the comb on this side. We can see that beautiful white beeswax there and all the perfect comb that they built. It's nice and flat, which is exactly what we're looking for. And what do we have inside here? A bit of pollen, nectar, and some sealed honey. So that's a thing of beauty. We'll move over here. Take this frame out, lots more brand new comb on there. They've been able to raise brood and cap it over within that 2 week period. So they obviously got right on it and built this comb right away. The queen got laying on it, and we've already got a beautiful pattern of capped brood on that new frame. The cappings on when you have new comb like this are a light color. On darker comb, it's a darker color because bees move beeswax around and everything takes on that different hue. On this side of the frame, we've got some cappings up here. And in this area here, we have eggs and larvae all through here. Without the comb on this surface, the queen would have not had that room to lay. For the first week after we installed the nuke, we had cold weather and they would not have built any comb at all. So it was a really good thing that we had that feed on. We've since had a good week of weather. There's been some nectar coming in. But we're going to carry on and feed this colony a little bit more to try and make sure they draw the comb out all the way across. This frame here has no foundation, no comb built on it at all. And just looking down in here, these two frames don't have any comb built on them either. So we're going to feed them more. If we super the hive before they draw out these outside combs, they just kind of abandon them and they move up and they never draw those out. So the hive would be at a disadvantage going into the winter. So we'll close it back up, get the frames back in the same orientation, and then we'll put the feeder on. And we'll put on approximately 2 gallons of sugar syrup. Pour that in there. Pour some in here. And just to let the bees know there's a little bit of syrup on top, we'll pour a little bit down the middle, and that'll get them looking around to find that syrup. Then we close the hive up with the inner cover, and the lids. We're going to leave that collie for about a week now. We're back after a week. We are going to check to see how the feed we put in the feeder is doing at drawing comb out in the brood chamber. So we'll get the feeder off first. Well, I can feel there's no weight at all there. So that syrup is down. And we'll have a look. Looks quite good. They're looking down in. I could see more comb being built on these frames here than was there before. So we'll pull a frame or two out and have a look. Oh, there's a lot of weight there. So they've definitely got that sugar syrup stored away in the new comb they've been building. Lots of sugar syrup in here, capped over. Eggs down in the open area here. Beautiful drawn comb on this side. So I'll set that frame aside and look at the very outside one. I doubt that they've got a lot on there. Huh, they do have one side about 3/4 built and nothing on the other side. We're going to fix that. What we're going to do is we're going to put this frame in now on the outside, but I'll make sure to put the chunk of comb that had eggs on it towards the middle of the box on this side, and then we'll put our least drawn comb towards the middle. They'll really want to get that comb there for the queen to lay on, so they'll draw that out pretty quickly. And we've done that little switch around there to help encourage them to draw it out. They don't really draw out the comb on the very outside quickly, and I want to speed things up a little bit. So we've shifted that around so that they that outside frame is now in this position. We're going to check the other side over here. Yeah, they've done even less on this side, so there's nothing done there at all. What we'll check on this one. Quite heavy, lots of comb, just a little bit of comb. Okay, so what we're going to do with that is set it aside too. This one is completely drawn, full of honey, or sugar syrup honey. We're going to put that to the outside. Then we're going to put our least drawn comb right here. Get it over now close to where the bees really want to build comb for the queen to lay eggs on. It's nice and warm right now, so we don't need to worry about splitting these, moving the frames over like that. We'll now put this sheet here towards that, and we've got the drawn side on the far side there. We're just working that undrawn comb over more a little towards the middle where they're going to be working on it. We're not going to feed them anymore. We're done with the feeding. We have white Dutch clovers in bloom now, and when that comes in bloom in our jurisdiction, that means the start of the major nectar flow is on. We've got some good warm weather, even some hot weather in the forecast, so we know that we're going to have a good nectar flow coming along. So we're going to give this hive a super and let them carry on building comb on their own from there. So get some of those bees out of the way, so that when I put the queen excluder on, we're not squishing them. Set our queen excluder on. I think that queen excluders are one of the most valuable tools that a beekeeper can have. We can keep our brood comb separate from our honey comb, which is a really ideal thing to be doing. We've got a box here now with brand new frames in them, and we're going to be putting that on. Now, when you're a new beekeeper and you're dealing with a situation where you have no new comb, you pretty much have to put a full super of foundation on the hive. Now, you don't have drawn comb to work with. Later, we'll show you what to do when you do have a little bit of drawn comb and you want to get more done. But we're going to let the bees do this. This is actually beeswax foundation in wooden frames. Bees prefer that a little bit to the plastic, so We'll let them go to town, collect some nectar, and we'll come back later and see how they're doing at building the comb out in the honey super. Here we are back 2.5 weeks later. We've had some fantastic weather. Lots of nectar coming in because it's been really nice and warm, and the plants are just gushing with nectar while it's nice and warm like that. So let's see what the bees have done with all that fresh nectar. We'll go down to the brood chamber first, get the honey super out of the way. Oh yeah, there's some weight there, that's great. So there's obviously comb full of honey in that one. But let's see what they've done with those foundation frames that weren't drawn out last time. So we're going to look at this frame here and that frame there. They had the least amount of comb on them. I'll pry this one up first. Just looking down in, I could see that it's nicely drawn out. Very heavy, so it's full. And then looking at that frame, I see honey along the top here and this beautiful sheet of pupa with all that nice brown capping over top of the pupa there. Lots of new bees coming along there. Same thing on this side, more honey, a little less pupa. And then just looking down in, I can see that this frame is completely drawn out on both sides. So now we have a brood chamber full of comb available for the bees to use for raising young and for their storing the honey. So let's have a look at the honey super. Oh, awesome. There's lots of white comb almost all the way across. We're going to look at the middle frame first. When bees come up into the supers, they work on the middle combs first, draw them out, and then they work their way in either direction there towards the sides. So that frame is full of comb, full of honey, lots of weight to it there. And this one I see is just the foundation. So they haven't yet got to building comb on that. But we're gonna move it over just like we did in the brood chamber. So we'll shuffle that frame over, it's drawn. And this one's drawn full of honey. We're gonna put that foundation frame in there so the bees build comb on it right away. Looking at this frame on the outside, it's already completely drawn, so there's nothing to do on that side. We'll just leave it the way it is. This hive's ready for another super. So we'll just grab the super, same thing, all foundation. I like to top super, to put the super on top of the already full one here, rather than underneath. And the reason for that is that lets the bees completely finish this, cap it, ripen it, and so on, before they move up into another box. But we'll just keep adding more boxes as they need that for honey storage. So that's it for building comb for the first year. Once we get into subsequent years, we then have the comb that has been built here that we've extracted, so we have all this drawn comb. And that gives us a bit of an advantage, because what we like to do is to put foundation frames, brand new frames, in between frames that are drawn out. So we alternate that as we go across. This frame has lots of, it's sticky from the honey that was left over from extracting. So it helps draw bees up through an excluder up into the honey super. And then once they're up there, the fact that there's comb on either side of the foundation means there's a little less space in there. And so they build really good comb right on the foundation where we want it. And that helps with getting more comb built out as we need to. Down in the brood chamber, we may periodically need to be drawing out comb as well. If we're making up a split, we need to add more frames to go into the brood chamber. Or if we're replacing old comb or broken frames, we'd be putting foundation frames into the brood chamber. So what we do is put those in the second position here. And then as the season progresses, if they haven't drawn that comb out, just like we did earlier, we'll shift those over more towards the middle to get the bees to build a comb. Because where they want to raise brood, they will definitely build comb. once we've got our comb built, well, it's a real asset for the beekeeper. These are just some methods that work for us. There's other ways of doing this, but we really like these methods here. I quite enjoy the process of watching that comb being built, that beautiful, pristine white wax, and seeing the honey fill that up. It's really rewarding to watch. Those of you that are new beekeepers and are just building your comb, I'm sure you're going to really enjoy that experience of watching that being built. Thanks for watching. See you another time.